Hello students, my name is Suganya. Today let us study about our senses. You all have studied about the sense organ and its function. Now let us study how do we sense the thing. And these are the five sense organs, that is the ear, eyes, tongue, skin and the nose. And you know very well about the functions. For example, the tongue helps you to taste and also to speak. And the skin, which is the largest sense organ, and it helps you to touch and feel the things. So that is, our sense organs help us in being aware of the things happening around us. So we hear, see, smell, feel and taste with the help of our sense organs. Now just think, what would happen if we close our eyes and shut our ears? If we are no longer able to use our eyes and ears, which other senses will we use to know the world? So now let us study about in detail. That is, if one of the sense organs is not working, the other sense organs work in a very efficient way. Now let us see, how do we sense the thing? See, any of your sense organ, maybe eyes, ears, nose, tongue or skin, maybe you are doing any activities with that, maybe you are touching, talking or tasting, it sends a message to the brain through the sensory nerves, and the brain reads the message and it responds to that through the motor nerves, and the brain sends the message to the body parts stating that what activity we have done. This is how the sense organ works. That is, the sensing is done in the body. That is, the brain takes the message and sends the message through the nerves. As we discussed that, if any of the sense organs, maybe the eyes or the ears, does not work properly, what other sense organs the person will use? That is, he can use the sense of touch or the sense of smell. Let us see about in detail. So, our sense of touch helps us in feeling the texture of many things around us. So, our skin helps to feel or touch the thing. Our skin is connected to the brain through many nerves. And these nerves act as a messengers between the skin and the brain. Every time when we touch something, the nerves on the skin carry the message to the brain. Then the brain processes the information and lets us know what we are touching. For example, when we touch water, the nerves send the message to our brain. And the brain processes the message and lets us know that we are touching something wet, which can be water. That is, a sense of touch helps us in feeling the heat, cold, pain and the pressure. It also helps us in sensing whether something is rough or smooth, hard or soft, and wet or dry. It can compare the things. For example, if you touch a soft toy, that is your teddy bear, how do you feel? You feel it is very soft and smooth. The other example, when you touch a block of ice, how do you feel it? You feel it is wet. So these are some of the things you can feel. That is, the nerve sends the message to the brain and the brain processes and sends it back to us stating that what we are doing. Now, as we studied about the sense of touch, there are some things that we should not touch, which is dangerous for us. Let us see the things that should not be touched. There are some things that one should not touch. Touching these things might hurt or injure us or even make our skin itch badly. So these are some of the examples where we should not touch it. So that is the burning fire, the hot utensils, the scissors or knife which may hurt you, and some of the plants which causes itchiness, and they get irritation in the skin. That is the poison ivy. So these are some of the harmful things that we should not touch, because it is dangerous for us. It may harm us. So we get hurt with these things. And apart from this, we will also learn about the good touch and the bad touch. So it is more important to teach our kids about the good touch and the bad touch. So you all should know what it is. How do you feel about a good touch and a bad touch? That is, all of us like being touched by our mothers. So we can feel the love and warmth in our mother's touch. Thus, it is a good touch. However, the touch of all people is not same. We feel uncomfortable when some people touch us in an unfriendly way. We should stay away from such people, because the touch that makes us feel uncomfortable, scared and unsafe, that is a bad touch. So the touch which makes us comfortable is a good touch, that is a touch from our mother. The bad touch is that if an unknown person touches us, so it makes us feel uncomfortable, who touches us in an unfriendly way. When you feel that there is a bad touch, immediately you need to inform the parents or the teacher that if anybody is trying to touch you in an uncomfortable way, when they are trying to make you feel uncomfortable, so immediately you need to inform to parents or the teacher. How the sense of smell works. As we studied, all the sense organs sends a message to the brain, and the brain in turn sends it to the body part. Now, how the sense of smell works is, we have a receptors. They are the small cells in the nose. That receptors carry the signal to the brain. As we studied in the sense of touch, the nerves are sending the message. Here, the receptors, that is the special cells in the nose that carries a message to the brain. And the brain in turn gives us the message whether it is a good or a bad smell. For example, a delightful fragrance of a flower. When we smell a flower, how do we feel? It's a pleasure. So we feel it very good. And the same thing, the disgusting odor of rotten food or dirty shoes. So we don't feel like smelling it. So this is how the sense organs work. So here we saw about the sense organs. When some of the sense organ doesn't work, whether we can't see or hear, the other sense organs like sense of touch and sense of smell helps the people to learn about the things. Now, there are some people who do not have the capacity to understand the world in the same way as we are doing. That people are called as differently abled or special people. That is, the people who cannot see, hear, talk, etc. As these people do not have a sense of sight or sense of hearing, they use the other senses, such as sense of smell and sense of touch. And they will have a very well developed sense of smell and touch. So, for example, if some people who are not able to see or hear, they use the sense of smell and touch, and it works very efficiently. And the people who are blind, they use a script called Braille to read and write. And the same way, these people uses the sign language. The people who cannot hear or speak, they use the sign language to communicate with others. So even then, if any one of the sense organ is not working, the other sense organs work efficiently and it is well developed. Now let us solve some of the exercises. Choose the correct answer. An unfriendly touch makes us feel whether it is comfortable or uncomfortable. The next one is, the that is the hand or the nerves of the skin sends the message to our brain. Which sends the message to our brain? That is the nerves. Then the next one is, answer the following. Name the sense organs and its functions. Differentiate bad touch and the good touch. And name some things that are harmful for us if we touch. Thank you.